Frozen 2 is the sequel to the massive hit that was Frozen. And basically, Elsa is hearing some mystical voice in the distance, and it's causing some concern. And she might believe it might have something to do with her parents and her ice powers. So it's up to her and Anna, Kristoff, Sven, and Olaf to see what's up with this mystical voice and solve the mysteries and questions many of us have. And while I wasn't the biggest fan of the first one, while I did like it, I just didn't like it as much as everyone else, I was still pretty optimistic about the sequel. The trailers were really good, and they've done a really good job with the marketing on this movie. And so, I went to see this movie last night, and guys, let me tell you, I gotta be honest, I kinda like this more than the first one. Now, I know this is a very controversial thing to say, especially since with how many people really, really don't think this is all that great, but I gotta be honest, I liked this a little bit more than the first one, honestly, in my opinion. First off, as always, the animation is top-notch, from the character designs to the landscapes, and especially the visual effects, from the ice to the snow and water effects. It is really pretty. It's a really pretty movie and nice to see on the big screen, especially in IMAX. I highly recommend that you guys go check it out in IMAX. It is so beautiful. This movie's also really funny. I cracked up several times during this movie. Many of the best jokes come from Olaf, but there are also some really funny jokes that for the adults in the audience that had my audience cracking up. And by the way, for all you Queen fans out there, be on the lookout for a special joke halfway through the movie. It's pretty great. The songs are also really damn catchy, man. Like, I don't think they're as catchy and as great as the songs from the original movie. I mean, that's obvious, but these songs are still great. I have some of these songs still stuck in my head from last night. And guys, I kid you not, almost after every single song in this movie, the audience would immediately clap after the song would ended. These songs are that good. And so, if you got a little annoyed by the first film songs getting popular, I hope you have plans for the next 5 months. I also liked all the characters in this movie. You got way more Anna and Elsa, you got lots more Olaf, and while he does get a little push to the side, Kristoff still has some really entertaining moments, but more on him later. And as for the new characters, while we don't get to see that much about them, they were all pretty interesting, though I wish we could have seen a little bit more about them, but again, more on that later. And lastly, I enjoyed its mature tone and darker themes about the past and change, and while I don't think it lived up to its fullest potential, I still appreciated what the filmmakers were trying to do, and I think it served up just fine, just well as it needed to, and it doesn't really feel like it's talking down to kids. It's presenting itself in a mature and grown-up way, and I respect that. And you don't really see a lot of films that do talk about these much darker themes, especially in children's films nowadays. But while it still didn't live up to its fullest potential, I still found the tone and theming of the film to be really great and very well done. But like a lot of things, this movie does have its flaws. One flaw being that I feel like the first act of the movie is very rushed. Like, they really, really jump into the conflict of the movie very quickly and very fast. Too fast, in my opinion. And they don't really take a lot of time to establish the characters a lot, since they really just jump right ahead into this conflict, which kind of worried me about how this movie's gonna play out. But thankfully that wasn't for the whole movie, but you know, like, just slow down a little with that first act next time, please. Another issue I had with this movie is that they really don't flesh out the new characters all that well. Like, there's this tribe that follows the Enchanted Forest's ways, and then there's this Arendelle army, basically, and you really don't get to know a lot about them because they're barely in the movie and they don't really have time to really get into these characters, basically, which is a shame because I actually quite liked these characters, seeing them on screen. They had some fun and charming moments, but again, we don't really learn too much about them, so why should I care? And lastly, there's Kristoff, who has suffered from the horrible film disease known as the subplot, which is a fatal disease where a character has nothing to do, so they give him a pointless subplot scene on very, very old television shows that no one cares about. Kristoff's subplot involves him trying to propose to Anna, but he always finds a way to mess it up. And while yes, this does lead to some very funny, entertaining moments and an honestly pretty damn good song, it really felt cliched, and it really felt like they really didn't know what to do with Kristoff, and it's honestly kind of disappointing, because I like Kristoff. He was awesome in the last movie, and I loved seeing him with Sven, but that's what happens when film characters get this disease. It affects them in horrible, horrible ways, unfortunately. But with those issues aside, I still loved this movie. It has beautiful animation, hilarious moments, fun and lovable characters that you know and love, and a mature and dark tone that I really appreciated. I know there's a lot of people out there that really didn't like this movie as much as they did with the first one, so if you're like me and you weren't as big of a fan of Frozen as much as everyone else, definitely go see this. I think you won't be disappointed. But if you really like the first one, I suggest keeping your expectations low, because a lot of people go in with the high expectations and they left kind of disappointed. So that's my advice to y'all. But I still thoroughly recommend that you guys go check this out. This is definitely a really great time at the movies and a worthy sequel to Frozen. And those were my thoughts on Frozen 2. What did you guys think of it? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Comment down below and let me know. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you like this channel, hit the subscribe button. Follow me on all social media links at the end of the video. And until next time, guys, stay sharp.
Give up. Give up. You cannot do it back.